more fraction comparison. These fractions are negative. Ah, that's confusing. You know, one of my strategies when dealing with confusing problems is ignore the confusing part. Yeah, that's nice. You ignore the confusing part, and then you solve the not confusing part of the problem, and then you bring the confusion back at the end and see if it then makes more sense. So that's what we're going to do here, all right? Your job is going to be to remember the confusing part. So you remember the negatives. Remember the negatives. And I'm going to think about the problem as if they were both positive. Think about it that way. Work on it a little bit. And then you're going to confuse me again by reminding me about the negatives, all right? So that's your job. So now, if these were just both positive, we'd know what to do. We make the denominators the same. We find a common denominator, and we know what that common denominator will be. It'll be just 9 times 4. We can take the first fraction, negative 7/9, and we multiply that by 4 over 4. Strategically multiplying by 1, and this will make negative 28 over 36. And we'll take negative 3/4, and we'll multiply that one by 9 over 9. So what we've done here is made both denominators. Each denominator is the product of 9 and 4. And sure enough, as planned, the denominators come out the same. They're both 36, so my fractions are negative 28 over 36, negative 27 over 36. So now that the denominators are the same, we can compare them. 28 over 36, we know that 28 over 36 is larger than 27 over 36. What's that? Oh yeah, the negatives. Can't forget the negatives. Thanks for reminding me. Thanks for reminding me. We have to deal with the negatives. How does the fact that these are negative change anything? Well, when I get kind of confused with fractions, sometimes I'll just think about the number line. I remember that fractions are numbers. They live on the number line. These are going to be between 0 and negative 1. Now, on the number line, they're to the left of 0. We go this way from 0. If these were positive, they'd be that way. But these are negative, so we're going to go this way. Between 0 and negative 1, because, you know, I haven't gotten all the way out to negative 9 over 9. That would be negative 1. Negative 7 over 9 is going to be somewhere before we get to negative 1. We're going to go this way. So we'll put the first fraction, negative 28 over 36. You know, say that's right here. Now, where's negative 27 over 36? Because 28 is larger than 27, 28 over 36, we have to go farther this way than we will when we go find 27 over 36 by going this way. It's just 28 is larger than 27, so 28 over 36 is farther this way. So 27 over 36 won't be quite as far away from 0, which means negative 27 over 36 will end up to the right of negative 28 over 36 on the number line. So now, back here when we saw that this was when these were positive, 28 over 36 greater than 27 over 36. But when they're negative, negative 27 over 36 ends up to the right of negative 28 over 36. So negative 27 over 36 is larger. And that's the one that equals negative 3/4. And our key step there was think of the number line. Remember, fractions are numbers. Let's try another one. Oh. Common denominator is the product of 87,482. 1,031. Oh, no, not going to do that. Oh, it's going to take forever. What do we do? What's that? Negative? What? You're right. Only one of them's negative. That one's negative. That one's positive. Every positive number is greater than every negative number. And we're done. We're done. The positive number is larger than the negative number. Fractions are numbers. Remember that. And some of these problems get very easy. How about this one? Well, these denominators aren't nearly as bad. You know, we can go ahead and find a common denominator here. 403 over 101. We start off by multiplying that. We'll start off multiplying that by 150 over 150 because we want to get the common denominator. And let's see, 403 times 150. Yeah, life's too short for that. Forget this. There's got to be a better way to do this. Fractions are numbers. Let's think about that. That helped us out with the last two problems. Fractions are numbers. Check this one out. 403 over 100. Well, 404 over 101. That's easy. 404 over 101. That's just 4. So we see that this number is just a little bit less than 4. How about this? 600. 600 over 150. That one's easy too. Now all we're doing is comparing these numbers to nearby numbers that are easy. 601 is a little bit more than 600 over 150. 600 over 150 is 4. So this number is a little bit more than 4, and 4 is a little bit more than that number. So this number must be larger than that number. All we do here is remember, fractions are numbers, and we're done. Thank you.